Welcome to techiv.com channel. We are solution providers. I am Ben, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to use the puppet tool in Adobe After Effects to animate a character. First of all, create a new comp, and then drag your image in Adobe After Effects. Before we start, let me tell you what basically puppet tool is. Using the puppet tool, you can animate any character. You just need a PNG image of that character. Either you can create a solid, a character in Adobe After Effects, or you can import any image. If you don't have a PNG image, you can mask it out. To see how to mask out a character using Adobe After Effects, you can visit our channel. So, we are going to animate this character using a puppet tool. You see a pin here. This is basically the puppet tool. Select it. Before you start, you must make up your mind that what you are going to do with the puppet tool. I want this character to jump. So, let's put a puppet point here at this point. Now, before we start animating, you must know that at these puppet points, we can control the character. As you can see, that I can move the character. But at this point is solid. But when I control this point, the other points are solid. So that's how a puppet tool works. If I put a pin here, and I use this point to animate, you will see that the other two points are stationary and I can use this pin to control the character. So let's undo this. And for this animation, I'll be working with fields only. Here in the timeline, if you go into the properties, effects, puppet, and go to the mesh, open the D4 and you can see that puppet pins. Puppet pin number 1, puppet pin number 2. So, I want this character to jump. So, let's open puppet pin number 1. And we can put a keyframe here. Now, as you know that when a character jumps, mostly the leg opens or they're fully closed. So, we'll make his legs open. At this point, let's assume that both his legs are closed. Zoom into your timeline. There's a keyframe there too. Move ahead in your timeline. And open up the legs. Oh, wait. When a person jumps, he or she stays in the air for a few milliseconds. So, move ahead a few milliseconds and put a keyframe there too. And then, move back here. Either you can drag it back here or simply select these two. Press Ctrl plus C and then Ctrl plus V. Now, as you can see, the puppet opens his leg, stays there for a while. Let's get a little motion here so that it looks a bit original and then comes back. Now you can see that the puppet is acting like he's jumping, but he's not moving up. To do so, simply pre-compose your layer. Move all attributes to the new composition. Now what you have to do is to move this composition. At this point it starts to jump. Put a position keyframe here. At this point in timeline, this jump is almost complete. Move him up a bit. A little more. Now he's staying there for a while. Put a keyframe there again. and as he comes back to initial position, either you can drag your composition here or simply select this keyframe, press Ctrl plus C and then Ctrl plus V. To give it a more natural look, use the keyframe assistant and easy ease in. Convert these keyframes to easy ease. You can do so by pressing F9. Now, let's see a RAM preview. Now you can see that the character has a very nice and smooth animation when it jumps. If you want to animate his ears or let's say his arms, you can do the same. But remember, you have to pin all points at the same time before you start animating to avoid any trouble. Thank you for watching this video. Please click the subscribe button and visit www.techiwi.com to ask any questions if you have any queries.